Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about a new feature which is coming along with Winter 24 release. With this new feature, you will be able to transform your data within the flow. This feature is currently in a beta mode, but it's a very powerful feature. So without any further delay, let's go to Salesforce.org and see this with an example. So here is the Salesforce Winter 24 release note, and as you can see, this is the new feature which is talking about transform your data in flow, and this feature is currently in beta service. So I'll put the link of this release note in the description of this video. So now let's go to the org and understand what I'm trying to do. What I'm trying to do is that I'm trying to create a flow where I will select available account, and then let's say I selected this account, I click on next, it will show me all the cases that belongs to that account, and I'll select one of the case and click on next, and then what will happen, properties from the case will be used to convert the case to an opportunity. So let's build that in a flow. So here is the flow. I've already built some portion of the flow. Basically, first is the screen element where I have put a pick list. And the pick list value is basically all the accounts within the org. And then whatever the account that was selected, based on that account, I'm selecting all the cases belonging to that account. So this is a get record element, and I'm fetching the case where the account ID is basically the account ID which I selected from the first screen. And then second screen is basically a data table where I am showing all the cases that I've fetched for that account. Now, here, right after this one, I am going to transform the selected case to an opportunity. So for that, I'll click on this plus sign, and here you will find a new option called Transform Beta. So I'll select that, and then let's put a name as Convert Case into Opportunity. Here, this is my source data and this is my target data. So my source data is basically the case that I will select from the data table. For example, if this is a data table which is showing all the cases, whatever case I'll select, that becomes my source. So in the source data, I'll click on the plus sign, and here in the select resource, I'll select the cases, which is basically from the data table, and then it will show a first selected row, which is basically the selected case, or all the list of cases. So I am more interested about my selected cases. So this is what I need. But then I need to convert that to an opportunity, right? So I'll click on plus and I will select record. And then what I want to convert, I want to convert to an opportunity, and then click on done. So once this is done, I need to map the values from this one to here. For example, I need the opportunity name, right? So I'll click on opportunity name is basically case subject. So if I click on case subject here, then I can bring that to my opportunity name, and then there will be a link created. Similarly, my case description can become an opportunity description. Then I can select like my account ID, case account ID can be my opportunity account ID. My case contact can be an opportunity contact number. My case ID can be opportunity case ID, so that it will know this opportunity is created from this case. Few other information I need, which is basically the required field. For example, opportunity close date. So I've created a custom field called related opportunity close date. I select that, and that will become my close date. And the last one, I believe, is a stage. And for that, I've created another custom field on the case record, which is related opportunity stage. I select that and bring it to stage name. I think that's all I need. If there is a required field to create a record, for example, stage name, I cannot put a default value. I have to link to a source record. I don't know why, but I was trying to put some default value and it was not working. So that's why I created this custom field on the case record to map the stage name from case to opportunity stage name. But I was expecting that without doing the mapping, I can put some kind of default value in the stage name field or any field, but that is not possible. Or if you think it's possible, just let me know. Maybe I'm missing something. Please let me know if you can, if you are able to achieve that in the comment section of this video. That will be super helpful. These are the ways you can create your mapping. There is an option that you can create some formulas. For example, if you double click here, it will bring that FX, and here you can write your formula. So I'm not writing any formula for the time being. I am just keeping this as it is. And once the transform is done, what I want to do, I want to create the opportunity. So for that, I'll click on plus sign, and then I'll go to and go create record. Here, I'll give the name as create opportunity. And it will be one record, and then it will be convert case into opportunity. This one, and then save as, and then activate. Now I'll go to my org. Let me create a case first. Let's put an account as age, case origin is phone, related opportunity stage this, close state and put 31st. And here I'll say MacBook slow. Okay, and then click on save. Now I'll come back to my home page, and this is the flow I was talking about. I added that flow in the home section. It's a screen flow. So now I will select age communications, click on next, and this is a case I want to convert to opportunity. So I select that and click on next. And then if I go to my opportunity object, I see there is an opportunity created. Let's open that opportunity, go to the details section, and as you can see here, it opportunity name correctly populated, close state correctly populated, account name is good, and the case number looks good, stage looks good, so everything looks good. So this is a way how you can use this transform element to convert your incoming data and map that to your target data. There are more advanced use cases where this can be used. So I'll be publishing more videos in coming days to see how this new element can be used to handle more complex scenarios where instead of getting data from the org, what about if you call a HTTP method and get some JSON response, and how you can convert that JSON response, or how you can map that JSON response to one of your object, right? And create that object, populate that object. I hope you like this video. Please let me know what is your use case, how you are planning to use this new transform element. And please subscribe to my channel so that you can get to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.